One, two, three. Let's go. I will not comment a lot during first problems because they are just very, very easy. I care about increasing points. Oh, just print M. Just print M. It's not correct. Here. What? There is two here. What did they got? One, one. think something is wrong with the statement. If not, I will get back to this. It is too. Okay. Then what about this thing? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Fifth. They say it's three, I claim it's two. What a shitty contest. So much time wasted already. Thank you. Any bets on whether the round will be cancelled? I wasted time asking questions, damn it. 5 minutes there. Great. Just great. It's not exactly that, is it? For every robber, I will have this shape of allowed moves. or maybe. The point will just mean that this, at least one coordinate must be greater than me. This is a forbidden area, forbidden area, forbidden area. Yeah. This sort or something. Unrated? No. 15 minutes longer. No. Greater than this. Greater than that. I think that's it. Why doesn't this work? Okay, but I think there is a test where my solution will not work. This test will be one step is enough. One step up. Every set has a cost and every position. the cost. Want to avoid this. Will I just maybe just leave one row and one column? Oh, sets are given in the input. Do they mean that? Do you mean that this must be satisfied for every function f? I think I can do it if n is a power of 2. What if it isn't? n is even, then after I run some algorithm on the left and right part, if I split in the same manner, I'm fine. If n is odd, what if it's like 9? So 8 plus 1. Then this last element can be different, that's fine. What if it's 11? Oh. If it's in the same manner, then I'm good. Cool. I hope I didn't mess this up. I did mess this up. I see. And I guarantee that those two halves are equal to each other. Then there is one extra bit. An extra element. Maybe for even n, I can always make everything the same. Oh, take the biggest power of 2, like 16, and the small power of 2, like 1. If now you want to merge with 4, then combine 1 with 1 element, then with 2 more, and now we have 4 same elements, combine with another 4 elements. merge this with something before. I didn't update last. Submit or not. This is a cool problem. Now I like it. The first fine problem today. I mean, D was also perfectly fine. The first three are just stupid. Something is wrong for 6. After this, the first four elements should be equal. Okay, I see. Nothing is lost, just quickly solve E and let's move on to the more difficult problems. Would be nice to get Nutella back today. I just need kind of MST. One number can stay in every set. When I leave a few numbers, I connect them into a tree. In every set, maybe it's good to leave the cheapest element. Because one element in a set doesn't hurt at all. And then for every other element, sorted from cheapest. Then in sets sorted from the cheapest set, check if I can put it there. Find a union. I am completely not sure about this. think with this comparator I should now sort all the numbers. Union. If group of value is different than group of taken of s of 0, then we take you. This is wrong. What's wrong now? Am I reading wrong? Oh, see. Total plus equal FID plus P of X. Doesn't work because it's too big. Three sets, each has just two numbers, 1 and 2. 1, 2, 1, 2. Oh, I need to. Now, please work. Bad news. That's not like a usual mistake. Okay, I see wrong answer in test 3. But at least I have F. It isn't that bad. Maybe this is some implementation bug. Leave the cheapest. Sort by cost. not the same group. Should they really break? I should not. I should not. They have exactly the same solution. Next will be G. Nobody solved the last two problems. No. The time is big, so it's a huge test. It's a huge test. A lot of test cases, most likely. Okay, this seems correct. Now what about that? If everybody is in the first set. Why am I not putting two here. The cheapest guy should be here. One, the last element here, the last two there. Wait. There are no test cases, so this must be literally a big test. Sort from cheapest, so now from biggest. Do I always take the cheapest guy? Implementing a brute force. I will copy uni, but I will keep in mind that, well, I copied it, so it might be wrong in both cases. Cool. If I don't find a counter test, that's very bad, because it means that my logic is completely wrong. Oof. That's good news. I sorted things for my convenience. Now, those two are cheap. Cost of removing from those is big, so I should leave those elements, right? Okay. Cost of removing from here is small, so I should remove from here. This one stays, same for this and that. And then it seems that I do things in random order. Element zero indeed here doesn't hurt. Then this element. Will it be here? Why not in the last thing? I see an issue. So I should say 10-3 here, 3 and 4 there, and in the first one 1 and 4. I will then remove just 2 and 3. The cost is 30. Okay, 50 indeed. How to get that? This 3. What about sorting all available pairs? Return. The first is value. So the problem was just sort elements by cost. greedily take them in this order if fighting union doesn't forbid so. That was easy. And I have a terrible place. If I solve G, I still have a terrible place. Of X are from the same set. F smaller than XY. Inside the set, it's cheaper to send data than from a set. Find the very cheapest edge. Can it happen? Okay, sets can be of size 1, then there are no conditions. But if A is in size at least 2, I need to think. Need to think. this is not within a group. Okay, I misunderstood. So some prefix of edges is side groups. I see. Can there be a lot of solutions? From one. Everything alone. Whenever we have some clicks, is this problem like really, really trivial? Hard to believe. Sort edges from smallest and just check when we have a bunch of clicks. Every connected component has proper number of edges. That's it. Should I implement this or just analyze or just draw this? Minus one. That's not true for sure. And that's impossible. What do we have? One and three. How am I supposed to get numbers bigger than one in the output? I should think more before implementing. Oh, yeah. Because now I have some connected components. Let's draw. Thank you. How can this be true? My first interpretation was right. Damn it, there is X here. Oh. Okay, so from this from component. Either one is alone. And two is alone as well. Or one is with two and with whatever subset. I will need to find strongly connected components. I'm almost sure about that. And then some 3DP. I am alone or with my parent. Maybe 4, 2 and 3 can be together in this? Why not? The biggest inside is smaller than anything outside. So not only the smallest matters. Not good. If the biggest inside is 7, then all edges going outside must be 8 or greater, and so what? I will think with my microphone off for some time. I think I got it. Some interpretation of a tree. I just need to introduce the pin this tree, but it seems cubic. Oh, the sum over sizes of subtrees is quadratic. Ways to get 0 is 0 and 1 is 1. Okay, I am done. Two, three, four, three, one. And this was a nice problem. And this is very bad news. How can I get wrong answer on test 12? Just checking if it's quite common to get this wrong answer. Oh, it's me. I hope that it's just some small implementation mistake. How can this be wrong? I'm trying to see if maybe there are some overflows. But I don't see any. Why? 10 minutes. I'm hoping to get some assert failed. Maybe, just maybe that will help. Come on. Sort. God, bad. I'm becoming desperate. No, I passed n equal to 1. Instead of extra, I will have this. Well, minus 76. So I'm back at 2850. Not great. What is the issue here? Two, four, four, three, five, three. I don't know. I can grab in a moment code from one of my friends or something and stress test with that. Then I will understand the issue. I think that the algorithm is correct. It also passes quite a few tests. So I don't know. Maybe again I made a bug in find a union or something like that. Let's see. Where's my union? A and B become group of A and B like this seems fine. I don't even need to do this step. Strange. Anyway, thank you for watching. Congrats for people in the top for solving all problems. I liked this problem G. I like the final solution, assuming that I have a correct solution. F was also fine. F and G were two cool problems. Everything before that was... I didn't like that. And also B was obviously bad. Why physics problem? Why? Which problem was physics? The one where you have some speed? People don't complain, at least yet. That's it from me today. Have a nice day. Bye bye.